How's it going, movie interview fans? Welcome back to another review on the Film Nerd Review channel, and today we are looking at a very special film, 2021's Spencer, starring Kristen Stewart and directed by Pablo Larraín. It's a, as the movie says itself, a fable from a true tragedy. It's basically 3 days. It takes place over 3 days, Christmas Eve, Christmas Day, and Boxing Day at Sandringham, and it follows Princess Diana. Now, I've never been someone who's cared that much about the royal family and the things they do and any part about it, really. I don't like any of it, but in the case of Diana, she's always been someone that's very much interested me, and when a film like this came along, I must admit, I wasn't the first one to jump along and see it. Far from it. I saw it towards the end of its theatrical run here in the United Kingdom, and actually, it wasn't because I wanted to see it. I went to go see it because I watch a movie reviewer who actually, the BBC News' movie reviewer called Mark Kermode, and I watched his program called The Film Review, and I think it was the week after it came out, or a couple of weeks after, where he said it was still best out, and I listened to him talk about it, and I said, this is a film that I really want to catch now. He's made me want to go see it, so I went and see it, and yeah, I fucking loved every moment, every single frame of this film. It's truly one of the most beautiful films I've ever watched. From the performances, to the score, to the script, to everything in and around it, it's truly one of the best films of last year. And it's just that reason that makes me love this film so much. It's a rare treat. It really is filmmaking at its finest, and it is art, in my personal opinion, and I usually don't say that lightly. The story's gripping, and it really keeps you invested the whole way through. You really feel sorry for this character, that you really, you know, get gripped in her story and how it's told. Kristen Stewart is literally fantastic as Princess Diana. If she doesn't win the Oscar for Best Performance, I'm going to be hella pissed, because she fucking deserves it so much. She is fucking phenomenal in this movie. I can't lie. She is probably the best part of this entire movie, other than one other element that we will get to in a minute. She literally shines through as Princess Diana, and this is definitely her best performance to date. And that's why I love this film so much, because she's so good at playing Princess Diana in such this way that it makes it an almost genuinely perfect movie in that regard. The cinematography and shots are absolutely stunning. You know, it is just a beautiful, beautiful work of art, in my opinion. And then there's the small thing of Johnny Greenwood's score, which for me is probably, it's really hard for me to say which I prefer, his music in Spencer or Alexander Desplat's music in French Dispatch, my favourite score from last year, but they're both fucking fantastic scores, and at least, well, as we're talking about Spencer here, the music in this movie is fucking phenomenal. Johnny Greenwood is a fucking god when it comes to composing music. He is far better than Hans Zimmer, and this is some of the most fantastic film music I've ever had the pleasure of listening to. I love the entire fucking thing. It's so perfect. It's such a beautiful score, and he was snubbed. I would rather have had him be nominated for this than Power of the Dog. And that is the hardball truth, because I don't think Power of the Dog's music is as good as it is here, and it's very, very sad that he was not nominated for this for an Oscar or a BAFTA. It was Power of the Dog that took its place. They had the option of two Johnny Greenwood scores from 2021 to put in the place to win Best Original Score, and for some reason, all the award shows fucking chose Power of the Dog over the work of art that is the Spencer soundtrack, which really pisses me the fuck off. But even still, this movie is just, it's really something. It's so mesmerizing. It truly is one of my favorite movies I've made, and I don't say that lightly about movies that came out last year, but it really, really is. I fucking love every frame of this movie, every second of this movie. I love Sean Harris's character, he's brilliant. The Major Gregory, I give props to the actor, because he really portrayed this nasty piece of shit character that no one likes very, very well. So I give him, the actor who plays Major Gregory, major props in that. I love this movie. It's beautiful. It is so fantastic. And I had the pleasure of showing this movie to my nan the other day, watching it with my nan the other day, who really liked Anna, and she loved it as well, which is, you know, something I'm happy about. She very much enjoyed the film, and it's one of a couple movies from last year that I'm going to be showing to her, because I think, you know what I mean. But I'm just glad she liked it. I watched it with my entire family the other day before this, which is why I didn't talk about this movie yesterday. I was originally scheduled to talk about this movie yesterday, but I talked about Licorice Pizza instead, so I could, essentially, the second time I watched this movie was yesterday with my family, and then this is the third time I'm watching this movie. But I fucking love this movie so much. I highly implore everyone to watch this movie, because it's not what you think it is. It's not some stupid piece that is saying the royal family's fucking brilliant. It's not. It's the very opposite of that. It's showing them to be as bad as many people see them as. The movie very much takes Diana's side. There's a reason why it's called Spencer and not the Royals or something else, because Spencer was her surname before she became part of the royal family. So it's about her and her alone. And like I said, Kristen Stewart is fucking phenomenal in this movie, and if she doesn't get an Oscar for this performance, I just hate the Oscars already. I've already got enough reasons to hate the Oscars. That would then definitely be the final of final straws, to be honest with me, honest with you, because this movie is so exquisite. I adore every minute, every frame, every shot of this movie is just beautiful. And it was shot on film, not 35mm, which is, or whatever's usually done, which makes it look so, it looks so raw and so brilliant. There are a few movies, I always say this, there is no such thing as a perfect movie, but there are a few that come quite close, and in all regards, this is one of those movies, in my opinion, that draws you into this world, much like Boiling Point, I don't believe it draws you into the world as much as Boiling Point does, but that's only because Boiling Point is one beautiful shot, which is why it draws you in. I still think this movie draws you into its world and its characters so well, and it really makes you see things through Diana's eyes, which is exactly what it was trying to do. Which, and I implore everyone to go watch this movie, listen to this movie. Soundtrack is available on digital now, and it comes out on CD on April 8th. I just think this is one of the best movies to come out of Hollywood last year, and it's been snubbed for most Oscars anyway, because it's not even nominated for Best Picture or anything like that in most places, because again, it's, you know, the whole movie is fantastic, but there are two elements that push it far and beyond anything else, and that's Kirsten Stewart's performance and Johnny Greenwood's score, which really push it above and beyond any movie I've seen in a very long time. And it's the funny thing is, I was never going to see this movie originally, because it was never really for me. I've never really liked the royal family, but I like Komodo. I like what he says about movies, and I go and watch movies when he says he enjoys them. And at that point when this movie came out, he was saying this was his best movie of 2021, so I thought, well, if he fucking loves it, I'm gonna give it a shot, and I'm glad I did, because it is, in all due respect, one of my favorite movies ever made. It's true cinema and more. It's wonderful. It's such a heartbreaking movie as well. But yeah, it's just, yeah, no, I love this movie and everything about it. It is beautiful. It's such a fantastic movie. and I implore everyone to give it a shot, because it is, without a shadow of a doubt, one of my favourite movies of all time. And I just fucking, please, go and watch this movie. However you watch it, because its cinematography, its script, its score, its performances are all jaw-droppingly fantastic. And I was often left speechless at how wonderful the movie is. Yeah, this has been my review of one of my favourite movies of 2021 and one of my favourite movies of all time, Spencer, starring Kristen Stewart and scored by Johnny Greenwood. Thanks so much for watching. Again, this is another movie in our Academy Award nominees season. So, Oscars and BAFTA season. And although it is not nominated for Best Picture, which is a fucking shame, it is the only Oscar nomination I think this movie has. Is Kristen Stewart is nominated for Best Performance by an Actress in a Motion Picture, which is already shocking enough to me, because it's just, it's too good to be as good as it is, and it's one of those movies that I don't think the Oscars deserve a movie this good, so I'm kind of glad it's not nominated for much more than that, because it doesn't deserve to be in the Oscars, it's that fucking good. Again, all of this is my opinion, take it with my own grain of salt, but again, every movie I watch, I say, you know, at least go and watch it at least once, make up your opinion, and hey, maybe spread it across the internet like I do. Thank you so much for watching. Have a wonderful, wonderful day. Don't forget to check out all the other videos on the other channels. We've got some very, very exciting videos coming soon across all channels. Go watch Spencer and have a wonderful, wonderful day. Bye bye for now.